Hey, what's up, guys? This is Neal Reyes, and I want to welcome you to today's episode of Champions Minute. Today, we're continuing our series on the types of prayer, and today we're covering praying in the Spirit. Get ready. Today's topic that we're going to be speaking about is called praying in the Spirit. Again, today's topic that we're speaking about is called praying in the Spirit. And in fact, as I was before the Lord, you know, right now we're covering the different types of prayer, and we've been covering them over the past couple weeks. And today we're covering praying in the Spirit. But as I was before the Lord and was seeking exactly what He wanted me to teach on this subject and how He wanted me to get it across, one of the things He showed me was that we're actually going to take more than one day to cover this particular topic. When we talk about praying in the Spirit, we're specifically talking about praying in tongues. Now, praying in the Spirit doesn't have to be directly praying in tongues. It could also be praying in your native language, whatever that is, whether that's English or something else. But most of the time when you're praying in the Spirit, you're actually speaking in tongues. And since this is such a broad subject, or I should say such a big subject that people have so many opinions about, and most opinions are just based on secondhand knowledge that they've heard. In fact, I'll tell you that many churches across America, even the ones that believe in speaking in tongues, don't believe in necessarily practicing and speaking in tongues. Or they're so guarded over allowing tongues to be spoken within their church because they're so concerned about, you know, the interpretations or things of that nature. And so today we're going to talk about praying in the Spirit. Now, one of the things I'm going to tell you that we're going to do as well is that next week, starting next week, the Lord has informed me that we're going to go ahead and be picking up a new series, and it's going to be over the 9 gifts of the Holy Spirit. We'll go over a little bit of that later within this teaching, and we'll touch on that at times within this teaching. But starting next week, we're going to be teaching on the 9 gifts of the Holy Spirit. And the reason why I bring that up is because as we talk about the gifts of the Holy Spirit, we're going to directly be talking about praying in tongues. We're also going to be talking about the interpretation of tongues, and we're going to be talking about prophecy, which ties those two together, and we'll talk about that next week. Today, I want to talk to you, though, about praying in the Spirit. Praying in the Spirit is one of the most vital things you can do when you're praying. In fact, in your prayer time, one of the things it tells us is praying unceasingly. When we pray in the Spirit, that is something that we can do at all times. It does not have to be out loud. In fact, I will tell you, it's powerful to do it out loud, but you have to be selective about when you do it out loud. What I mean by that is when you pray in tongues, it's not edifying to someone else. In other words, it doesn't build them up. Why? Because they simply don't understand what you're saying. And when they don't understand what you're saying, edification through praying in tongues is meant to build up your spirit. And there's different supporting reasons on why you pray in tongues or different things that come from that. We'll cover that within this mini teaching. But that being said, praying in tongues is something you need to be guarded over doing in front of others because you don't want to throw them off. You don't want to make them go afraid or, you know, go astray or scare them or something. But it's something you can do at any time. And I will tell you that as a believer, you should speak out loud in tongues as often as you can when you're in private or in your home. But you can pray in this at any time. In fact, you can be in a business meeting. You could be, you know, at your work, at your desk, whatever, and you could be praying in the Spirit. Now, some people might say, well, why would I want to do that? Well, stay with us over the next day or two because we're going to cover that. The first thing I want to get into, though, is what praying in tongues is. When you pray in the Spirit, you are directly fellowshipping with God. Now, how do we do that? Well, when you become a believer, and be mindful, no one who is not a believer, in other words, if someone is not saved, if they have not received their salvation, they are not filled with the Holy Spirit, and they will not be able to speak in tongues. Now, that doesn't mean that there's not imitators out there. And that doesn't mean that there's not people out there who can pretend. I remember listening to Jesse Duplantis a while back, and he was talking about a meeting he was at, and he was talking about how they'd come around and lay hands on people. And this is when, you know, before he got saved. And he said he was talking to a guy, and the guy said, man, if they come around here, I'm going to act like I can speak in tongues. And he was saying something silly like, someone has stolen my Honda. Someone has stolen my Honda. Someone has stolen my Honda. And what he was saying was, someone stole my Honda really fast. Someone has stolen my Honda. But he did it over and over, so they thought he was speaking in tongues. It was kind of funny. Anyways, when you're speaking in tongues, what you're basically doing is this. You're allowing the Holy Spirit, the Comforter, which God has given to us, to speak directly to the Father through your spirit, man. Now, I might have lost some people there. So like I said, we're going to take our time and break this down. When you're speaking in tongues, you're allowing the Holy Spirit that's inside you to speak through your spirit, man, to the Father. He'll do it in utterances. He'll do it in groanings. Sometimes he'll do it in tongues of men or tongues of angels. But he's speaking directly to the Father through your spirit man when you yield to that. Now, why would you do that? Well, it tells us in the Word that the spirit cannot understand the flesh, and the flesh does not understand the spirit. Who is the devil? The devil is not a spirit devil. The devil is a flesh devil. I'm going to say that again. The devil is not a spirit devil. The devil is a flesh devil. And when we're praying in tongues, when we allow the Holy Spirit to pray through our spirit to the Father, we're praying about things that the devil does not understand, because spirit does not understand flesh, and flesh does not understand spirit. We're going to take our time and really break this subject down and go over what it means to speak in tongues and why it's beneficial. But what I want to share with you is that as we do this intro teaching to speaking in tongues, we're going to be covering over the next couple days. And as we do that, we just want to share with you that speaking in tongues is something that is vital to the body of Christ. In fact, I want to read you a scripture where it talks about it. Some people feel that speaking in tongues does not happen anymore. They feel that was something that happened within the Old or New Testament when Jesus was around and right after he left, but that it doesn't happen anymore. I'm going to tell you that that's false. In fact, it tells us that in Romans 8:26. But first, I want to read you another scripture. I want to read you 1 Corinthians 14:2. This is what it says. It says, "For he who speaks in a tongue does not speak to men, but to God. For no one understands him. However, in the spirit, he speaks mysteries." So remember, when you speak in tongues, it's so you can speak or pray in the spirit. You're praying directly to God. And when it says you're praying mysteries, it simply means that it may be something that you don't understand what you're praying about, but the Holy Spirit does, and it's something he needs you to pray about so that he can go to work for you. Remember, faith without works is dead. It's one thing to believe in faith, but it's another to operate in faith, because there you have a required action of you. You have to operate in faith. And the way you operate in faith is by speaking out God's words. And when we speak out God's words, sometimes that's the direct scripture from the Bible. But other times that's allowing the Holy Spirit, yielding to the Holy Spirit, to pray through our spirit man to the Lord. I want to read you one more scripture before we close, and this is out of Romans 8:26. And this is for all the naysayers out there that say that speaking in tongues happened only right after, you know, in the book of Acts, and since then it hasn't happened. Well, in case you don't know, Romans comes after the book of Acts. Let's go to Romans 8:26. This is the Apostle Paul talking, and the reason why this is so important, all the original 12 apostles learned directly from Jesus, but Paul did not learn from Jesus. Paul received his instruction directly from and through the Holy Spirit. That's so important, because it's the same Holy Spirit that led and taught him that is teaching us today through the Word of God. Let's read Romans 8:26. It says, "Likewise, the Spirit also helps in our weaknesses. For we do not know what we should pray for as we ought, but the Spirit himself makes intercession for us with groanings which cannot be uttered." I'm going to read that last part again. "But the Spirit himself makes intercession for us with groanings which cannot be uttered." Guys, when we pray in the Spirit, we're yielding to the Holy Spirit to speak through our spirit to God. And it's something that's definitely around today. Now, if you don't believe in that, that's okay. I'm not pushing this on you. I'm not saying you have to speak in tongues. But I'm telling you that as a person who believes in God, as a believer, if you're not praying in the Spirit, you're disabling or refusing to use one of your most powerful spiritual weapons you've ever been given. In fact, I will tell you that praying in the Spirit, when you talk about your spiritual arsenal, ranks right up there with the name of Jesus and with the blood of Jesus. It is so important because it is the Holy Spirit praying through your spirit, man, directly to the Father. It's like having a bat phone directly to God. I talk about the bat phone, but back in the old Batman days, you know, they had the bat phone where they'd call Batman when they needed help. And then they went to the spotlight in the sky. You know, it's like having that direct phone that goes to the president, that red phone they show on TV sometimes. This is so much more powerful than that. This is a direct line to go directly to the Father whenever you need to pray about something. Whether you understand what you're praying about or not is irrelevant. It's directly going to the Father and praying about it. Guys, I hope you enjoyed our teaching today. Like I said, stick around with us because over the next couple days, we're going to talk about praying in the Spirit. We are just dabbling in it now, but we're going to talk about the importance of praying in the Spirit, what you do with it and why it's important, and we're going to talk about benefits that come directly to it. And when we close our teaching series out, we're going to close it out with how you can receive the gift of praying in the Spirit if you haven't received that already. Guys, as always, we want to remind you to swing by our website at neilreyes.com where you can check out all of our teachings 24 hours a day at no cost. You can stream them on there 24 hours a day. In addition, we invite you to check out our YouTube channel where you can subscribe and share it with friends. You can also find us on Facebook and Twitter. Guys, as always, we want to remind you that Jesus is Lord and He loves you, and so do we. Thank you and have a blessed day. Drop.